In this video, you will learn how to create and optimize your Walmart product listing. And our guest today will be Norm Farrar from the podcast Lunch with Norm. And he is also quite known in the Amazon sellers industry with his knowledge he's sharing. And but this time we'll talk about Walmart. Before we go on with the content, I wanted to mention that this session is part of Seller Fest Online Virtual Summit, which is supported by three companies. The first one is Carbon 6. It's a suite of tools that makes it simple to optimize and streamline every aspect of Amazon sellers business or Amazon business. And you will find the link to Carbon 6 tools below in the description. The next company is QUARTILE. It's an AI-powered advertising optimization platform that helps sellers and brand owners to maximize the potential in e-commerce platforms. You will find the link below for QUARTILE as well. And last but not least, Getida is also part of this event, and they are an Amazon FBA auditing company, and they help to maximize FBA reimbursements for sellers of any size. You can check their offer and the link below in the description. During the session, if you enjoy the content, don't forget to like and subscribe. And this session I'm co-hosting together with Lisette. Hi, Lisette.
Hi, Augustus, and hi to everyone watching us right now. I'm really excited to be here and also introduce our next speaker, who is Norm. And Norm will be go into details about how to optimize your Walmart listing. So hi, Norm.
Hi, how are you?
Good, and we hope you're doing good as well. And although Augusta said you're quite known in Amazon industry, could you still please introduce yourself and give us a short overview of what you do in the Amazon space?
Well, sure. One of the things that I do, I have my own brand. I've been involved with Amazon since about 2013-14. Luckily, I was already involved with e-commerce right back to the mid-90s. I've been involved with manufacturing. Had a couple of places in Taiwan, and now still have a factory in China that technically own. But anyways, this all helps with Amazon and understanding Amazon and all the elements involved with Amazon. So my company right now has a sourcing capability. So it's called Honu, which is sourcing and logistics, supply chain management. But most importantly, we do a lot of product innovation. Our company right now is more of a brand management company. So not only do we take people from Amazon and work with them, we also go into Walmart and taking people off Amazon as well into retail. So that's my experience. I won't get into it. It's boring.
No, thank you so much for this short intro. So meanwhile, you prepared your screen to share your presentation with us. I wanted to mention that after Norm finishes his presentation, he will answer to all of Walmart related and Walmart listing optimizations related questions as well. So if you have anything in your mind already right now, you can type those in into the chat box. So somebody says, I know this. That's Kai.
That's my son.
Oh, okay, very good. So yeah, Norm, go ahead, share your screen, and let's see what you have for us.
So one of the things I wanted to do is really talk about Walmart. It's such an amazing platform. It's a new platform. I got excited about Amazon in 2013-14, and I started to ride that wave. I want people to get excited about Walmart as well. It might not take off as fast, but I know some information that Walmart is not standing by and allowing Amazon to just manhandle them. So anyways, today I'm going to be talking about optimizing your Walmart listing in 10 simple steps. Before I do that, I want to talk to you about going out and simply finding a product. There's a few things that you have to know first, and I'm going to give you a couple of facts. So why Walmart? Well, you want to take advantage of the new opportunity on Walmart. So when I'm talking about on Walmart, it's not Walmart, the stores, it's the Walmart marketplace. So that's their online service. I'm going to talk a little bit about Project Glass too. This is the future of omnichannel. And I will get into that a little bit later in the slides. customers can get, just like in Prime, up to 2 days shipping. And the Walmart app, I don't know if you know this, but this is the second most popular app out there. There's 86 million users using Walmart's app. Now, the other is there's a tool in their growth opportunities called product listing optimization. I'm going to get into that a lot later on. And that's going to show you what Amazon really doesn't help you out with. They do. There are some internal tools, but wait till you see this. Walmart really wants you to succeed, and this tool will help you. Also, the untapped potential. There is zero to no competition in many categories. You won't believe the numbers once we get into this. So here we go. Here are the categories. Did you realize, and I was shocked, I was talking to DataSpark about this. They actually supplied me with this slide a few months back. And Walmart actually has more sales. So if you take a look at beauty, health, clothing, there's more sales on Walmart than on Amazon. So Walmart has equal to or better pricing than your products over on Amazon. So beauty, health, clothing, home improvement, home, and there was one more. Oh, sports and outdoors. So just kind of keep that in mind. Also, one of the things I like about Walmart's business model is very different than Amazon's. If Amazon started to open up some retail locations, but Amazon has 110 fulfillment centers. Now, Walmart has a ton of stores, but they are converting and working with 5,000 stores to work with this next generation Project Glass, which is going to allow them to have way more ease of fulfilling their products. Imagine 5,000 locations compared to 110. Simple growth. They went in one quarter, they went from $39 billion to $75 billion in e-commerce. That's not a quarter, that's a year. So $39 billion to $75 billion, that's almost double their growth in 1 year. And this year, I think that's going to double. This is a number that I really like, the unique visitors. With your Amazon account, there's 214 million unique visitors going to Amazon every month. With Walmart, there's 118 million unique visitors every month. So what does that mean? So active sellers, there's 1.5 million compared to Walmart's 100,000 active sellers. Now that number is probably growing. There's a lot more exposure, but the information that I'm using is a few months old. This is growing every day now. So imagine that 218 million is divided into 1.5 million sellers compared to 118 million, which is divided into 100,000 sellers. So when you compare, that is 143 unique sellers per unique visitors per seller compared to 1,100 on Walmart. I think these numbers are crazy. So it's actually an 832% difference. Now, let's talk about Project Glass. Project Glass is the new face of Amazon, and you'll probably see this changing in the near future, but Walmart, just like Amazon, is constantly changing. They're giving us the opportunity. We've all seen this now, if you've ever gone to Walmart recently, that they're giving you an opportunity to pick up the product. You can use your app, you can order, and you can pick it up at your local Walmart, which is usually fairly close to any suburb or within any suburb. You can have it delivered by that local store, or you can have it delivered through WFS at one of their warehouses. So this gives you the chance, gives you the power to do whatever you want. If you're out and about, I said about, I'm Canadian, so you probably picked that up with the about. Anyways, with the pickup, delivery, and shipping, that covers all the bases that you need. So I like this, and I'm sure this is even going to get more fine-tuned as things start to roll out with Walmart. Now, the next slide is there's really five things that you should check out before you start your listing. And I'm going to share this with you now. And the first thing is you want to find your niche. Walmart is different than Amazon. And depending on what your niche is, you could be entering into something, let's say something's very popular over on Amazon. Maybe it's a dud over at Walmart, or it's a dud on Amazon, but people are looking for it because of the demographic over on Walmart. So just kind of keep that in mind. I got this slide again from DataSpark, and they were kind of showing us what were the best looking niches. And if you take a look at the top right, I mean, grocery is just a killer out there. So food, grocery, health, there's a lot of really great product niches that you can get into. Number two is finding selection gaps. So there are 600 million SKUs on Amazon and only 100 million SKUs on Walmart. So what are those gaps? When I saw this slide, I fell off my chair, because what it's showing you is the competitive or the lost opportunity that people have on Walmart in different categories. So lost buy box opportunities for cell phones, 981,000 electronics. Let's go down to sports and outdoors. There's 26,000 opportunities that you have with zero competition or very, very little competition. Pets, 7,000. Home improvement, 21,000. We're talking categories here that are showing up on Amazon, but not in Walmart. So there are plenty of things that you have that you can get involved with. And I put over to the right left-hand side, I mean, kind of memories of 2014, where you could just pick what you wanted to get into. And with the right research, you could just get into the market and compete very easily. But you can't do that without doing your keyword optimization. And one of the things that you can do with your keywords is you can go, and there are tools available, and I'll show you that in a sec, but you can also use Amazon or Walmart and Amazon to go out and check out, you know, what are the best keyword phrases. So I typed in gifts over at Amazon, and this is their drop down. And as you can see, if I put gifts here, the completely different group of keywords are in Walmart. I mean, this just tells you, I wanted to show you to say it's completely different. The more relevant the keywords, like gifts for women, gifts for men, gifts for mom, completely different than gifts for girls age 11 and toys, girls for gifts for girls age 11, and then same in age 8. This just goes ahead and shows you that there is a difference. There's also, you can go in, and like I was just mentioning, you can go into the search bar and you can just take a look at the keywords that drop down, but there's also a category listing that you can see some other keywords. And that's, if you see the red, the very first red at the top. And if you take a look at the bottom, you can see that there's an options tag and there's an ad. So these ad buttons, I mean, it's just pretty cool that you can have these different options. So you can click on that and see the different variations. So you can just do your competitive analysis. Apps. The one that sticks out in my mind, the one that I use is Helium 10's app. They've come out, I think they were probably the first that came out with this, but there are different there are different modules that you can use for your Walmart keywords that and I'm sure that Helium 10 is going to be expanding out on this, but you can see that it's a completely different market. You can go over, you can check out your Walmart listing, and then you can compare it with your ASIN. So they'll have the Walmart listing, then they'll have the ASIN, and also just very similar to what you can do with Amazon. You can see the revenue, you can see reviews, you can see how tight your information is. Now, Carrie was on yesterday, from what I understand, and she showed me this, and it blew me away. So we were looking, we were kind of putting together a presentation, and she said, "Norm, take a look at what I found." And we found this garlic press, and it was the number two garlic press. I think it's over here. It's the number two garlic press for revenue. And we went to this garlic press listing, and it was absolutely horrible. Anybody could have competed with it. It just had one, just one image. Nothing was done. But we took a look, and the same listing, the same horrible listing, was over on Amazon. So we could take advantage of not only Walmart seeing this horrible listing, but also going back to Walmart and checking it out and showing that you could do that. So just do your research, do your keyword research, see what pops up. And it's so, just like your Amazon, if you don't have the images, if you don't have a proper written title, the description or other attributes, you can go in there and just kill it. The next is the power of search. Now, one thing that Walmart does very well is work with Google. I'm going to give you a couple of examples, and you won't believe what you'll be able to see. So I believe 44% of traffic to Walmart is driven by search traffic. So I think that's pretty cool that Google is working so close with Walmart. But here, for example, this is a very competitive product on Amazon. It's number seven in Amazon, and yet you can't find it anywhere when you go and search on Google. You can find the Walmart listings, and in fact, you can find three Walmart listings, but you do not see Amazon on here at all. Next, same thing with socks. So this is a number two in men's socks is Hanes brand. And if you take a look over here, 14 of the top 30 are in Walmart. So all you do is you type it in, Hanes socks, you don't see anything. So I don't know, I mean, if you can see the importance of this and the options or the opportunities here, having Google populate this for you is so impressive. Another is find a community. I think you're going to see more and more Walmart communities popping up, but there's so many questions and so many things that are changing all the time. Get into a Walmart community. If you're serious about it, get in there, become an active member, make sure, like, check out the engagement and see that people are, you know, it's not bots in there, that it's actual people that are answering these questions, and there's experts in there. Remember, when you join a community, everybody has an expertise in something. Well, if it's a Walmart community, I highly recommend this. Now let's get into the listing. So I'm going to be talking about 10 different things: registering your brand, product title, product description, images, rich media, ad reviews, apply for WFS, apply for Connect, listing score, and seller badge. As important in Amazon, you have brand registry in Amazon. Here you have brand portal, which is brandportal.walmart.com. It's a very similar process. There you'll find that many people have already taken products that are yours from Amazon and are selling on Walmart. So you can eliminate that very quickly by just showing that you own the trademark. And I found Walmart to be very good at this. Number two, pay attention. This is so important. So if you're taking notes, this is the note to take and put on your computer. If you got a sticky note, do not cut and paste your Amazon listing. If you've already done it, if you've already tried and thought, oh, I'm going to do that, and you're going to be ghosted, or you're going to have less chances of promotion than somebody that created unique products. So one of the things Amazon does not want, if you're drop shipping, for example, they don't want an Amazon smiley box showing up. They want they don't want a brand on it at all, or their brand, of course, but they're not too happy if they have to compete with Amazon on their listing. So get unique product information. And like I said, that's real, by the way. If you're doing any drop shipping and you're allowing it to go in Amazon boxes and Walmart catch you, you could have your listing suspended. All right, so unique content. This is the other thing. Don't go crazy with long titles. Not going to work. It's not the same. There's a very specific format, which is 52 to 68 characters. And keep in mind that mobile phone is where people most of the time look for your product. So 36 to 52 characters. Still, a slight majority will find on mobile, and the majority will still sell on desktop. So just kind of keep that in mind. So balancing that 36 to 52 or 52 to 68, that's up to you. But mobile is where people are searching. Now, the titles can be very specific. So you want readable titles, but there is a formula to it. So you've got your brand. If you're doing clothing, it would be, if it's applicable, you would put it here. You would put your product item, any defining qualities, the name, the style, and the pack count. And you can find out this formula. You can go right to the help section in Walmart, and they're going to provide this. And by the way, Walmart has an incredible help section. So if you log into their seller dashboard, you can go to their help section and see really good videos, really great guidelines, and they'll just help you out. I find it's I think it's much better than Amazon's. And then on the product descriptions, this is back ass words. So it compared to Amazon. So you can include the product name, brand, and keywords describing the item features and benefits and related keywords for customers that are likely in the search. So they're not saying like keyword stuff. You have to make it engaging. But here's the difference. The description has to be a minimum of 500 characters. And when you do the keywords or the attributes, it has to be a minimum of 80 characters. So this is incredibly important that you keep that in mind. So 500 characters and then 80 characters. That's the minimum for every attribute. Now also keep it readable and engageable. Make sure that customers will engage with it. Use keyword rich but readable sentences, like I just said, and don't get into salesy or promotional language, just like Amazon. They don't want you to have the used car salesman type approach. So anyways, that could get you in a little bit of trouble. And most important of all, make Walmart unique. It's so important. Images, slightly different. You can do 1,000 by 1,000 or 2,000 by 2,000, but they want you to fill up that white space. And if you don't fill that out, the images aren't going to show. Also, if you have lower resolution, so under 1,000 by 1,000, they're not going to show. You're going to end up with a warning, and you can fix it there. But if it's under that, they want high quality images that you can hover over. Do not show accessories, similar to what Amazon tells you. Don't show accessories within your primary image. You are free to do what you want in your other images. many Amazon or Walmart sellers are still just putting in minor amounts of images. So this is where being an Amazon seller, you already know how important that is. Now, I know somebody's probably going to ask the question, can I use the Amazon images? You can, but I just like changing it up a little bit, you know, just asking my graphic artist to do something different. So again, it's unique content. I don't think that that's a big problem, but I just do it because Walmart asks for unique content. And images, this isn't anything big. You know, get it over 50% white space or it's not going to be accepted. So if you're not filling up that frame, first of all, the product that you're trying to sell probably will suck. So make it larger so it has even a higher perceived value. If you have this really tiny image, but it's a nice picture, people are going to think it's in a smaller package, or it's just not as good as the one or two that are using bigger white space. Now, rich media, Walmart, I keep getting these. Oh my, I'm so sorry if I keep going Amazon. I'm so used to talking about Amazon, but Walmart, at the beginning, when they first launched, I think it was November, Project Glass, they had three third-party hosts that would take your enhanced content, your video, your comparison tables, just a bunch of everything that you could pretty much do in A-plus content or stuff that you could load up in Amazon yourself, you'd have to go through a third party. So they stopped it while they were rolling this out. But companies like SKU Ninja or White Spider are companies that you can go to for this type of service. And I don't know, there's different costs for this, but just check it out. But you can have something that's similar to A+. And again, whether it's on, whether it's off, it just depends when you're looking at this recording. This is very interesting. So one of the things that you need to do when you're optimizing your listings is have reviews. Well, if you're just brand new on Walmart, how do you bring in reviews? Well, if you have Shopify, you can go to review syndication and you can import them. Not only can you import them from Shopify, you can also import from Amazon, but you have to import all the reviews. You can't leave the one stars out. Everything has to be represented. Now, there are apps out there like Yopto, and this is for Shopify. So they'll just bring in all of your reviews. You'll see them. And this helps give you an extra additional ranking or optimization when you get into the listing optimization app. This is one of the elements that will help you sell. So just like Amazon, people who are looking at your product listing want to make sure that that the reviews are there and that there's trust. There are three types of listing or freight options when you're opening up an account. And at first, it might be seller fulfilled. You might be sending it out from your garage. You might have a 3PL that you're using. Typically, you're using you're fulfilling it yourself. And that's the worst. The reason for that is you're going to have a 5-day badge or a 7-day badge. Just like on Amazon, sellers aren't looking for that. So there's partners that they have. Deliver is one partner. If you're accepted into their program, that's an option for an automatic 2-day badge. So people have that trust and that authority that you're going to be able to deliver on time. The best form of delivery is if you can apply for WFS and you'll get that 2-day badge, but people just like seeing WFS. So first, seller fulfilled, get started, get your listing optimized, apply over to deliver, or you can try going directly to WFS. 6 months ago, it was a lot harder to get into WFS. Now it's a lot easier. We've been able to get a lot of our clients into WFS without even trying. It's, they might come back and ask a few questions and you just answer the questions. One of the, we talk about this during the application process. You have to fight more for your brand than you do on Amazon. They're going to ask you questions like, why do you think you're a fit? Well, you have to fight for your brand. So they might ask you questions like that, like, why do you want, why is it important to be fulfilled by or use WFS? Give them the answer. Fight for your brand. I've seen different questions that have come in that kind of didn't make sense. But anyways, fairly easy to get going once you get your listing set up. And it could take a few days. It could take a few weeks. You might not get accepted to WFS. If that's the case, go back to Deliver. The next is Walmart Connect. So Walmart Connect is like Amazon PPC. There are three, there's actually five, but there's three that we as sellers can work with. The first one is sponsored ads, which will show if you go to Amazon or if you go to Walmart right now, you'll see every 10 positions, you'll see a sponsored ad, and that's in the search results. So that's the first one. The next one is a buy box ad placement, which can show up on your competitors. And that is very popular as well. And similar to Amazon, there are display ads. There is a big difference here, and just be careful. When you're bidding on these, if you bid $20, if you bid $100 over on Amazon, you might get like the next penny over for the bid. It's an auction. And all you have to do is they'll give you, oh, how do I say this? You're only going to pay very little for the next bid up, right? With Walmart, they're going to take the money. So if you're bidding $100 per click, they're not going to go down to the lowest bid and add a penny. They're going to take your $100. So you have to be very careful. You have to monitor this. You have to play around with the listing to make sure that you're not getting gouged. So this will help optimize, deliver a ton of traffic to your site, especially if you have it properly optimized and with reviews. Now we're into the fun stuff. I get into this in the VIP section, into listing quality score in detail, but this is an app which runs in the seller central, or sorry, into the seller dashboard. And what this allows you to do is really unleash your listing's potential. It's going to look something like this. So you're going to have your product listing. You're going to see that in this case, it's low priority issues that are causing a problem. You're going to see the product category, the overall listing. And if you can see over in the far right, here are the four things that make up a listing quality score: the content and discoverability. So all the content, all the attributes, are they filled out? In this case, no, they weren't. There was a detailed description, but it might be too small. The attributes, there are probably 100 attributes here. And if I click on that listing score, I'll show you in a second, it'll give you a scroll down menu where you can see where it's asking for more information. Your offer, does it make sense? You know, is it too high? Is it too low? In this case, it's running at 51%. And then the ratings and the reviews. I don't even know why we got a few here. There were some reviews on the overall listing, or sorry, on the overall campaign, but not a lot were done, and also post-purchase. So content, offer, ratings, and post-purchase. You're not going to get any post-purchase because right now we don't have enough sales that have gone out. The next step is to take a look at your content, like at the bottom here, and you can see that there's multiple issues under the description. And so I'll click on the listing, and this is what it'll be. So this is the actual listing. So if I go back up here, I go to the top left, I'm clicking on the Triceratops. From that, I'm going to come over here and oh, by the way, where you see this is under analytics, hit growth opportunities, and then the listing quality score. So now it's going to get into detail. And also, you're going to be able to check your progress in three areas. Pro seller badge, you're going to see the listing quality score, which will be just very similar to what you saw in the last slide, and your post-purchase quality. The other part here is you're going to see the score, and it's going to reflect the content, offer, ratings, and post-purchase. But when you hit details, it's going to have a drop-down menu, and you're going to scroll through that drop-down menu, and you're going to edit each one. And if you know the information, for example, SKU or a manufacturer, I just did a pet listing, type of pet, size of pet, pet options, like pet, the types of different pets. You fill in all of this information, and every time you do this, your score, your listing quality score will go up, go up, go up. The target is you want to be over 70%, especially if you want to get the pro seller badge. Pro seller badge requires a score of over 70%. Once again, important content discoverability, offer, ratings and reviews, post-purchase. The last note is pro seller badge. You'll get way more sales, just like the prime badge, but it's going to build trust. It's going to build authority. It's going to build trust. People are going to see this. They're going to see that you passed certain restrictions to get this, and it's going to increase your conversion. It's also going to increase the amount of exposure that you have. And like I just said, once you have the badge, it's going to build trust and authority. How do you get the badge? So you have to have defect rate of less than 10%, cancellations less than 2%, a listing quality score, which we just went through, 70%, more than 100 orders in the last 90 days, trust, safety, or performance standards. Like, you can't have any of those issues, and you must be an active seller for 90 days. Very quickly, the buy box algorithm is looking for price, shipping, and performance. And that is it. That's the end of my slides. If you want to contact me, you can get me here. And I'm sure these will be downloadable. So that is it. Let me stop the screen.
Yeah, go ahead. Take a moment.
Yes, and I did take a note you suggested. I found a yellow sticky paper.
Oh, very good. That's
yeah,
good.
Yeah. So what did you say? Do not copy paste Amazon listing.
That's exactly what I said. I'm glad you were listening.
Yeah, thank you.
So yeah, Norm. Yeah, I wanted to say big thanks from our side as well for this very comprehensive presentation about Walmart and optimizing Walmart listings. And to the viewers, if you enjoyed what Norm told you about all of the details, then definitely like this video and also subscribe to our channel as well.
And this session is is part of the Seller Fest online virtual event, where we asked every 25 speakers to provide additional VIP session, VIP video. And Norm already mentioned during his presentation that he provided additional recording, and you can find the link below in the description to access the page where you can upgrade to the VIP package. So this package includes over 20 videos from every speaker, where each of them adds additional very often workshop style actionable content. Maybe they do a case study, they share a template, they share a checklist. And Norm, what do you share in your VIP video?
Well, I dig into the VIP. I dig into the listing quality optimization and go through it in detail. Every field, what you have to look for, how to enter it. So we're just looking at, and probably the most important thing that I talked about, other than what you had stuck to your head, is just making sure that you're completely, completely optimized in this area. And this is an area that a lot of Walmart sellers overlook. Like, they're the fields. That's only a handful of the fields.
Yeah. So, yeah, you can take a look at the VP package. And once you upgrade, you will get access to all the videos. And you will find the link below in the description. All right. So now it's time for Q&A.
All right. We did receive a bunch of questions for you. So let's get started with Daniela's question first. So when you say that Walmart has better prices, do you mean the prices are cheaper, so it's better for the buyers, or more expensive, which would be better for the sellers?
Yeah. So Walmart as a whole had better pricing in those categories. Your pricing strategy might keep them the same. I hear people saying, oh, I lost my buy box because I was on Walmart. You can keep them very similar. They want to be able to compete together. I believe that both operations are not allowed to lose. You can't lose the buy box by having a lower price on a different platform. I believe that was something that was resolved a few years ago, I think. But anyways, usually what I'll do is, if I'm having a sale over at one, I'll adjust the price over on the other as well.
Okay. And generally speaking, do you find when you go around in Walmart, are the prices lower than you usually see on Amazon platform, or are they more expensive?
A lot of times they're the same. So people are trying to keep it consistent. Where you might see it different is on their Shopify store.
Okay, very good. So Adam is asking a question. So how can I, as a UK-based seller, start selling on Walmart? What difficulties do I face, and how do I overcome them?
Well, Walmart, it was tougher even for Canada. So their application process could trip you up. They're going to ask you some questions about being an international seller. They really were looking for US-based businesses. Just to give you an example, they were asking whether you had a warehouse outside of the US, whether you sold outside of the US. Even though I do, I mark no, because I wanted to make sure that they saw us as a US-based company, and that was it. Recently, I went into my Walmart account, and all of a sudden what happened, I think it was on the weekend, I got, hey, how would you like to, sell in Canada? Oh, that's interesting. Now the UK's opened up. So I don't know the specifics on what you would need to do from a UK side of things. What I would try is, this is not like Amazon. You can go through the application process and get rejected, and don't worry about it. Just appeal or come back again. A lot of the times, the reason why you're getting rejected is because you're W8 or W9. So usually W9, I would never talk about W8 even a few weeks ago, but your W9 did not match the information on your EIN. So you're going to have to upload, this is in the US, your EIN number, like the actual form from the Department of the Treasury. And that's usually you would just supply the number, but they're going to take a look at that, and it has to match. And if that doesn't match, you get rejected a lot of the time. And that would probably be the same over in Europe. You just have to make sure that if you're in UK, that everything matches. I have not worked with one person from the UK because this is still fairly new. So yeah, sorry, I can't answer it completely.
Yeah, but thanks still for the tip you shared. So Javier is asking, what ranking strategies do you suggest on Walmart as opposed to Amazon?
Well, one of the biggest ranking strategies is get that listing optimization. That tool will do magic. The other thing is, make sure that you apply and get that PPC connect. Now, no different. One of the best tools that you can work with is Google Business Profile. So for ranking strategy on multiple platforms and getting things going, You can drive traffic over to your Amazon listing. You can have an image that drives over to Walmart. You can do all of that. But no different than anything else, you can use all sorts of external traffic. I typically call it a traffic blitz. If you have a Shopify store and you want to get some traffic going, hey, ping your or email or, you know, get the information about a new product launch you're doing over at Walmart. And Walmart, by the way, very similar costs to like referral fees to Amazon.
Okay, good. So Sheila is asking a question. Probably she participated in yesterday's speaker panel, which was also about Walmart. So she says another speaker said that they don't suggest importing reviews from Amazon to Walmart. Do you have any insights about that? Because you mentioned, I think, that it's possible to import reviews from both Shopify and Amazon, right?
Yeah, that's correct. The first thing is importing from Amazon is very tough. Second part to that is if you have reviews on Shopify, it's easy and there's no issue importing them into from Yopto or we do from Yopto into Bazaar Boys, which is just their app, their API that allows you to import everything. Amazon could be a little bit tricky. The word that I hear is Amazon doesn't like it when you import their reviews, but I do know people that do it. But if you do have those reviews from Shopify, get them in there or any other platform.
All right, we have a few more questions. By the way, Aiza says it was very informative presentation.
Oh, thanks. And,
yeah. Javier wants to know, do you know if feature sets will come back for rich media?
That's the trick. That's why I said, depending on when you see this, I'm hoping that everything will come back fairly soon. There's different opportunities. Like there's so much going on right now, and there's things that are going to be happening. There's always changes. So I don't know that answer. But I can't wait. But when they do come back out, I think it'll be bigger and better. And I don't know if Walmart's just going to take this on like Amazon did and just have the services hosted themselves. Not 100% sure.
Mm-hmm. Ongaro would like your email. Maybe you can share your last slide again.
Sure.
Oh, here. Ah, yeah, we have written here.
Okay. Yeah.
And so it's N at lunch with the Norm.
Yep.
All right. So Shayla, our product have an issue, missing attributes such as items included, but we already state included items in the title. Is there a certain verbiage, I don't know how to pronounce, we should include in the title to comply?
Well, if you take a look, this is an excellent question for the help center. Just like the style guides in Amazon, you can download information about the titles and it'll tell you exactly what, like if it's in inches, is it IN or do you have to spell it out? If it's a carton, is it a one pack or one carton or one CTN? Depending on what you have, the items included, you want to just make sure that that's listed correctly. Also, when you're going into the fields in the listing optimization, there is a eye, like a blue circle with an eye, and sometimes that will talk to you about the attributes or whatever you want to get involved, but what you need to do or what is actually wanted. And maybe the interpretation of what actually is wanted and what your perception is are two different things. So they do give you these blue circles with an eye that you can just hover over and get the info.
All right. Ed Sexton says good stuff. And Freddie has a question. By importing reviews from Amazon to Walmart and our Walmart price is lower than Amazon, would it surprise suppressed the buy box on Amazon?
Oh, this is such a tough question. So if this was a year ago, I would say absolutely that, like, what we were finding is people that had products listed on Walmart at a lower price usually had their buy box taken away. From what I understand, I can't confirm this 100%, but I was talking to an attorney that was handling something along these lines. I was told that legally, Amazon could not penalize you for having a lower price on Walmart. So coincidentally, I still see that. But that's why I try to keep it the same. Like, if I'm having a sale over at one, I'll try it over at the other. But from what I understood, they're not allowed to do that. And usually if you find that you're losing the buy box, it's because you've priced yourself out of the buy box. Like, you've either upped it too fast, or you've the algorithm doesn't think you can sell at a certain level. And so that's could be the reason why you've lost the buy box, not because you have a lower price. And this is all just speculation based on what I was talking to the attorney about.
All right, perfect. So I think we're done with the session. And one more time, Norman, can you mention all your projects? How can people find you? If you want, you can share your last slide again.
Okay, so let me just see. I put up that last. So here it is.
And yeah, we will. While you are sharing your screen, I wanted to mention that if you enjoyed the content about Walmart, which Norm shared, I think it was really informative. Check the like and subscribe buttons and click on them. And now let's see for the slide with the contacts.
Yep. So there's a QR code that's going to give you all of my information. But if you are looking, it's n@lunchwithnorm.com. And I run a podcast every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at noon Eastern Standard Time. Always looking for new people to join our community.
Yeah. Can you maximize that screen?
Sure.
So we don't show your private corners.
There we go.
Yeah. Perfect. So yeah, take the screenshot or scan the code. All right. Thank you very much, Norman.
Okay.
See you next time.
Well, thanks for having me.
And thank
you.
See you.
All right. See you later. Bye.
Bye. And now I would like to invite you to watch the speaker panel, where we had three experts from three companies answering Walmart questions in more details.